Let's explore how you can use design libraries in Figma Buzz so you can insert and swap components and styles and customize your layouts while staying on brand. Similar to building templates, the process for adding libraries to Figma Buzz starts in a design file. Open up the file that you want to host your library in. A great place when starting to build out your library is to think about your styles. Frequently, we think of this as typography and color styles. You can visualize them and add them to your Figma Design library, which will be very helpful for designers that are using Figma Design to create Buzz templates. But you can also publish these styles out and utilize them in Figma Buzz. In this example, I'm creating a color style. I'm going to click on the element on my canvas that has the fill of the style I want to create, head to the four dots that says apply styles in variables, and within here, I am going to select the plus button and toggle over to style. Here, I can type in the name appropriate for the color and then create the style, and it is now added here. So when I publish this, it will be a part of my library. Next, create components that will essentially act as reusable design elements and are frequent across your branded assets. These will surface in the inserts panel in Figma Buzz and often include things like reusable illustrations, iconography, UI pieces, and even logos with different dimensions, different formats. Once you created your assets, it is now time to publish your library. To do so, head to the left side panel, click this book icon, and you will see the assets created in this file is referencing this current library that you are about to publish. And once you publish this out, it will then be able to be turned on in your Figma Buzz environment. Now that we've published our library from Figma Design, within Figma Buzz, we can add the library to the file by heading to the Inserts tab in the left side panel. We simply click Add Library and toggle down to our organization, click on our collab assets here, and simply add this library to our file. Now within our inserts panel, you can see we have our collab brand assets with all of those components that we have created. If you would like to get specific about what libraries are enabled per file whenever somebody creates a new Buzz file, make sure to go to your admin settings and toggle which libraries are turned on by default. This is a great way to jumpstart people into a new file and get them using the correct branded assets. Now that we have our library turned on, we can start to customize our design here. I can simply click on the preview thumbnail of the asset, or I can drag and drop onto my canvas for more precision. From here, I can scale and even utilize some positioning options. The amazing part about adding inserts in Figma Buzz is that I can also further customize if these components from our design library have variants set up. So maybe I would like to swap this out for a different flower option here. I can simply do so and continue to rearrange and play around with this design. I can even do so for this object here and swap it to the correct photo for my layout. Just like that, we've customized one of our templates by utilizing our inserts and staying on brand. We also mentioned how it's important to set up your typography and color styles because these can be brought in and utilized once you toggle on your library in Figma Buzz. For example, say I want to swap out this purple background color for a different color we have available in our brand library. I can click on the asset, toggle into our fill options, expand, and you will see those four dots to apply styles and variables. Once I do so, you'll see all of our collab style colors here available to swap out. And maybe this time I want to swap to a blue. And that's pretty simple to do. You can do the same thing for your text styles as well. So these can be found within your typography dropdown. Open up and apply styles, and all of the styles we define in our library will surface here. To recap, open up your design file that hosts your library, which includes any color and typography styles, as well as components that you want to utilize in Figma Buzz. Make sure you go ahead and publish that out, and then open up your Figma Buzz file and toggle on the library within the inserts panel, or head over to admin settings and set it as a default library for Buzz files to use upon opening. I hope this video was helpful and inspired you to start to think about ways you can utilize libraries in Figma Buzz. Happy creating.